time, NBC 15 in the Kalahari Resort in the Wisconsin Dells are treating you to one night stay and two all-day passes to their indoor theme park.
Every Friday, we draw another name. You have till noon the following Monday to email us or call us to claim your fabulous prize. Who's got one today? Do you remember?
Yeah, Raven Simone.
Oh, yeah.
Remember her on The Cosby Show?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And The View?
Yes. She was a baby model.
Really?
Yes. And then she kind of made her way into acting, and she was very popular on some Disney shows as well. She's 30 years old today, and she, like you said, her newest thing to add to her resume is The View.
All right, today's National Lager Day.
Okay.
On this date in 1884.
You made the font even bigger for yourself.
I know. But I put a line through it.
Oh.
It's 1884. Mark Twain's Adventures of Huckleberry Finn was published.
Yeah, nice.
1901 on this date, the first Nobel Prizes were awarded. 1965 on this date, the Grateful Dead's first concert performance under their new name occurred. 1965.
Okay.
And now for your viewing pleasure and
Let's
in part the bring you down moment.
Oh.
I give you the Beechcraft H-18 twin-engine plane. Oops. One of these babies took off from Cleveland Airport on this date in 1967. Destination, Madison, Wisconsin. The people in that plane were scheduled to appear at the Factory Nightclub near the UW campus on December 10th, 1967. As they were coming into Madison, they radioed in for a landing but did not make it to Truax Field. That Beechcraft H-18 ended up in Monona Bay, mm-hmm. and they salvaged it the next day. If you can look in the lower right or lower left portion of your screen, you can see the word Otis on there, the Capitol building in the background. Otis Redding's plane crashed on this date in 1967 into Monona Bay, killing Otis Redding and four members of the band, the Barclays. One survivor of that plane crash, but he couldn't swim, so he couldn't rescue anyone. Incidentally, his song, Sitting on the Dock of the Bay, the only song of his to ever go number one, went posthumously to number one after it was released in January of 1968. It went to number one. It was the first song ever on the Billboard Hot 100 to go to number one posthumously for the artist.
Interesting. Okay.
Yep. So, yeah, this date in 1967, Otis Redding died in Lake Monona.
Big story
yes,
in Madison.
It was. There's a plaque out at a park near Lake Monona that commemorates that. So,